Hello, hello. How is everyone doing? I hope everyone is having a good Saturday. Feels normal to be streaming on a weekend again. I had that one weird stream last week on a Thursday. Just because it was a public holiday and the whole stream I was saying, "How's your Saturday going?" I forget what it's like to stream on a weekday. I feel like I used to stream on weekdays all the time when I was at still at school, but it's harder to do during the now that I work, but it is what it is. And it's a sunny day, so I got a bunch of chores done today. That was good. And now I'm back coding again, which is probably not the best thing to be spending. Oh my god, this thing keeps falling off. Okay. Let me switch over to this screen. Hello, I'm wearing my Pikachu shirt today. It's pretty cute. I picked up my train tickets. I'm going to Amsterdam next month for TwitchCon, which is pretty exciting. And because I booked my train tickets a month early, I got a really good discount, so that was good. I still need to find a place to stay. That's like one last thing to do. I booked my flights and everything, but yeah, I still need to find a place to stay. I'm just very indecisive about where I want to be, but I should probably do that soon because it's gonna be really expensive otherwise if I like do it the week before. It's like a month still, so I have time. But yeah, maybe I'll just do something tomorrow. I don't know. It'll be fine, probably. All right. Let me see. So last weekend, I basically got started on this, and then I kind of gave up. Well, I didn't give up, but I got stuck, and then I didn't really feel like streaming on Sunday because, I didn't really know. I didn't want to spend the entire stream trying to figure stuff out, so I kind of just did it off stream, and now I kind of know what I'm doing, so I can continue. Basically, what I was doing last time was, if you've used any of the stuff that I've coded, you'll know that I have a website for my documentation because, it's kind of useful to have for people who want to like do commands and stuff. But this is what the current site looks like. And it's workable. I mean, it works, but it's old. You can probably see the copyright thingy down there. It's not a real copyright, but I just put it in anyway. It says 2019. So yeah, hasn't been updated since then, which is pretty sort of a long time ago. But it's all good because we're gonna update it. So back when I made this, I used something called Vue. You can see the little thingy up there, Vue.js. And that's basically one of the JavaScript frameworks that exist out there. And then since then, I've kind of moved more towards React. So this was a really good jumping off point because I kind of got into React through Vue. And they're, you know, they have very similar sort of implementations. A lot of things differ, obviously, but it was a good sort of intro to JavaScript frameworks. So in this particular website, I'm using something called VuePress. I think it's still up. But it's basically a way to use Markdown to write documentation. So that's kind of what I did for this site. If you use Discord, which I'm assuming everyone does, you'll know what Markdown is because you can use it to format your messages in Discord. So this is pretty much the same thing. And it makes just like writing stuff like this way easier because you don't need to worry about like creating a website. You just write and then everything is put into the template, and so that's pretty cool. So basically that is the idea behind this. I'm going to be using Markdoc, which is a authoring system from Stripe that basically lets you do that. And yeah, last week I was getting the thing set up for letting us do that. So yeah, the thing that I was struggling with last week was getting the the layouts working. So I have nested a whole bunch of nested layouts. Well, not nested. I have nested transitions. So you can see when I change the page content, the actual layout of the page isn't changing because it's the same layout. So like this nav bar, for example, and this sidebar, this doesn't need to change because it's just the page content changing. But if I go to a different type of layout, you'll see that now we're using a different type of layout where it's got like this hero banner thing. So then the whole page needs to transition. So that was kind of tricky to work out. I basically ended up making this wrapper component called layout wrapper. And I basically keep track of the route. And that way I can reuse this for the page and also for the content. So that's pretty neat because now, where is my here, I have the layout key. The layout key is the key of the layout, and the root itself is the page content. So it was a bit of a challenge just because I had to consider Markdoc layouts as well, but we got there in the end. So we have this cute Shiba Inu puppy, and that is on this page. As you can see, I've just loaded that image in through Markdown, and yeah, that worked quite nicely. So now I just need to do more stuff. Basically need to create more layouts, and yeah, I need to start parodying, I don't know if that's a word, gaining parity with this website, the original website that is. So I don't 100% know how tables work in Markdown. I think I vaguely know tables, Markdown. It's like using a lot of types. Oh, extended syntax. Common mark. Okay. I wonder if this works. Let me see. So if I go to index on feature, that will be feature one. Let's see, put that there like that. And I put this here. No, we don't have a table. All right, it's gonna be interesting because I actually need tables. Mark Doc Tables. Strike. Tables. Oh, really? I can do this? Wait, is this an actual table? I might have just got rid of the styling. Oh, there is a table. It just... I think it deleted the styling. Huh. Interesting. It's probably not readable. The struggle making everything readable on the screen. I can't do that either because chat needs to go up on the side. I'll just do this. Right. Oh, if I put this at the bottom, there we go. Let's see. Table, okay. I feel like it deleted this table, original table styling. I don't know. I'm gonna try and put something in and see if that works. Oh, you know what? Do this. Mark dot bio. And check on the actual this site itself to see how it looks. Oh. I don't quite know how this works. So these are columns. Each line is a column. And each one of these is a row, I think. Looks like. I wonder if that's in the documentation. Tags. Table. Oh. Common mock tables. Oh, right, I see. Rich content. Tables without headings. Hmm. Aslo, what's up? Thank you for the honk. How are you doing? How was your holiday? Are you back now? I hope it was restful. Table. Okay. Try this. Ah, interesting. Ah, so I put headers like that. Can I do this? No. I guess this doesn't work for headings. Just enjoying my morning tea, nice. I don't have tea today. I usually make a tea before stream, but it's so hot today that I'm just drinking water. vacation was amazing. Place we stayed at was beautiful. Oh, that was lovely. Did you travel out of state or was it in Arizona? I'm kind of envious of how big the US is. Like, it's just like every state is pretty much its own country. You can just, you know, there's so much to do in one place. In the UK is like tiny. Oh, well, at least we have tables. I guess I can dial them. Oh, I should probably experiment with that, actually. Okay. If I do this, table, go width 100%. Well, that's kind of already doing what I want it to do, actually. I was in New York. There was a 5-hour flight and a 2-hour drive. Oh, wow. That's a long way to go. My knowledge of... Hang on, I need to look this up. I roughly know where Arizona is. I roughly know where New York is, but I don't know how far apart they are. Like, which states you have to go over. Oh, that's pretty... That's, like, cross-country. Damn. You go through New Mexico, Oklahoma. I mean, I don't know which way the flight went. I'm assuming it was kind of direct. Nice. What was it like being on the East Coast? Well, yeah, working on today? Yeah, so I could actually understand. Basically, the, yes, you do. I don't have any, there's no hot stuff. Mohonk. That's a cool name. Let me see. Oh, wow. What? That's so pretty. Looks like a Disneyland resort. Wait, this looks familiar to me. Hang on. What? You know what? I've seen this. Yes, I've watched Upload. I was about to say. I was like, I've seen that out. I recognize the, the thing, because that's a very distinctive looking thing, and I've seen that in the show. I was like, but there's, but I couldn't tell because there's normally a pier that thing there, but I don't know if that, maybe I'm misremembering the show. That's so funny. I haven't seen the last episode of the second series. I've got one episode left, but yeah, that's really cool. It's funny. So you were, Nathan, that's his name, right? Yes, Nathan, you got to be in, that must be so trippy. Is it exactly the same inside? You didn't know that until you got back. That's cool. Oh. I think I have to make that a must visit when I go. You was uploaded for a week, yep, and then you got downloaded again. Wait, so had you not seen Upload before you went, and you only found out afterwards that it was where it's filmed? Because if so, that's pretty funny. It's a good show, I like it. I think I prefer the first season over the second season, but it's still good. Yeah, it's nice. It's very meta. A lot of jokes, internet jokes. Actually, no, all the interior shots are not the actual place. Ah, just the shots of the outside are. Interesting. Oh, that's kind of... I mean, I guess it kind of makes sense. The interior doesn't kind... Well, now that I think about it, the interior doesn't really match what the outside looks like, but... Very cool. It does remind me that I still need to find a place in Amsterdam. I'll find something. We'll make it work. I didn't see it until I got back, powered through all the episodes when I got back, nice. I've got one episode left of the second season. It's fun. I'm enjoying it. Oh, alright. What was I doing? Oh, I was testing this out. Okay, let me quickly test this. So you asked earlier what I was working on. Basically, I'm kind of just experimenting with using this thing called Markdoc, which is a way to like make websites that have a lot of written content, like documentation websites, without like the hassle of making an actual website. That makes sense. That probably doesn't make sense. I don't have to create all of this extra stuff. I could just write it like I would write Discord messages in Markdown, and it gets converted into the website. So yeah, it's pretty neat. But then obviously I need to make the templates. I need to make like the layout and stuff, but then all the written content itself can actually be written out like text, like normal text. I'm kind of redoing my old documentation website. This was from 2019. It's a while ago. I was reading up on it. It was renewed for season 3. I wouldn't be out to... Oh, it's been renewed. I did actually look that up. But that's cool that it was renewed. I was kind of worried that the ratings for season 2 wouldn't be as good. Oh, that's something to look forward to then. Thank you. Web 1 stuff? I mean, yes. But it definitely could apply to the other stuff that we are doing. Who knows? The more I learn about this stuff, the more I kind of want to use it. Because the ideas that I had for that website, I was going to do one way, but I think I might do it this way. Not with Markdoc, but with Next.js, which I've kind of been using for this website. So it's definitely something to pursue, I think, now that I feel more comfortable with it. Let me see. Close this. Chat about stuff this week. Have a fun idea. Need you to tell me as possible. Alright. Sounds good. Sounds interesting. I'm always down. Okay. The cool thing about Next.js is that you can make different, what do you call it, pages just by making a new document. So, for example, here I've got /docs/feature. You can see that I have a folder called docs and a folder called feature. And that is pointing to index.md because that's the index of features. If I go to /overview, you'll see that it now goes to this file, which is this overview file. So if I change this description awesome to wow, that will appear there. So that's the cool thing about Next.js, is that you have this sort of inbuilt routing. Whereas if I did this as a normal React app, then I'd need to set up all that routing myself with React Router, and it kind of gets a bit wonky. So it's nice to be able to just like visually see that this file is this page. And you like, it's always this page. So if I refresh it, it goes to this page. If I go to overview 2, it goes to this page, which is just says this is another description. So it's pretty neat. Seems simple to navigate, yeah. Whereas if I was making it like the old way that I was thinking of, it would still be separate files, but it wouldn't be this automatic. Like this supports this stuff out of the box. Very cool. And because everything is rendered, like pre-rendered on the server, it's definitely better for SEO because Google can basically see all the content ahead of time, not mounted on the fly. So Next.js is usually recommended for SEO purposes. That not a thing. Inherently an excellent tool to achieve great SEO performance. Hell yeah. So yeah, I'm gonna keep experimenting with this to see what else I can do. I did manage to get all of this stuff working, which is pretty sweet. Oh right, the table. I need to think about that. I also need to figure out how I'm going to do these marked doc pages that have images on them, because if I go to this page before, like directly, it's going to give me an error. Oh, really? Oh yeah, there's an error. Because apparently the image doesn't exist when it's rendered, which I don't really understand. Like if I navigate to that page, I think I need to make a wrapper component around this image to be like, to just like load something blank. Going to lurk and lurk a bit, loading into Apex match. All right, sounds good. I might be on Apex later. I don't know if I'll stream it. I've been wanting to stream Apex, but I feel like I'm not good enough to do that, because I'll just get frustrated if I keep losing, which is not out of the question. Be right back. I do that streaming or not? Oh god, why am I so loud? Bruh. I mean, I guess so do I, but at least I don't. I'm not like visible when I'm molding. That's kind of a lie. I don't really mold, but it can be frustrating. I've been trying to record more of my gameplay, because I feel like it's good to review what I did or what I could have done. It's nice that way, because sometimes I have good matches and then I really want to go back and rewatch, but I couldn't. So it's more about if I have good games. If I just have bad games, I'll kind of review what I did, but then we'll just delete the clip. Because no one wants to save bad stuff. I'm pretty sure there's like an Nvidia thing that can automatically like save stuff. But I haven't looked into it. Alright. Let's see. Okay. Good luck with your matches though. What map is on right now? Apex Legends current map. It is currently World's Edge. And then it's Stormpoint. I feel like I haven't played an Olympus for ages, because every time I get on to play, it's just like not the map. It's really annoying. Alright. What are we doing? I am reading. Table styling. Let me go to global styles and then do table border x solid red width 100%. What are my tables usually like on this? Oh, it's not 100%. I guess it doesn't have to be. It could just be auto. Oh. Whoops. But I will give it some padding, so let me do that. So that'd be cells, right? TD and TH. You make that 0.5. You know what, I should just kind of mimic this styling if I can. I guess I can get rid of these. I'm gonna make these RAM. Oh, that kind of already looks like how I want it to. I need to change this border though. That should be the light mode border. I'll change it to dark in a second. TDTH. Oh, so it's not actually on the table. Makes sense. Okay, so if I switch this to dark mode, how did I change this? Oh, interesting. Okay, so I'm going to... How should I do this? When this is dark mode, that says up there, right? Data theme dark. Okay, in that case, maybe what I'll do is HTML, or if I do data theme dark, TDTH. Huh? Oh. See, this is where I wish I had, what do you call it? Sass. it looks more reasonable. And there was a, what do you call it? this weird, what is that? It's like odd and even. It's the whole body. Okay, so what I can do is let me expand this. I can keep the this fairly local to here because it's really only the table. TR. I guess I should apply it to the body onwards. How was I doing it here? I mean, this was the styling that came with the site though, so. Okay. Oh, here we go. It was TR and child 2N. Let's try this background. Wait, why didn't that work? Why did that not appear? Oh god, that's not what I wanted. So this was in light theme, and then in dark theme, TR, this. Ooh. Excuse me, oh, I'm so tired today. Wait, oh, this is a different type of dark background. This is like dark, this is like gray. I should switch it over to this one though, because this is what the site will eventually be like. Do I even know what color this is? Is this even a color? Did I switch? I might switch. Oh, I'm so thirsty today. Right, I think I'll make the header do the as well. TH. Okay, cool. Okay. And then it said in the documentation that I can use, where is it? Rich content.
Ooh.
Here we go. Oh, it's just like down a bit. Oh. I mean, that works. So can I not just put it on the same line? I can. Okay. Can I skip lines? Nice. Okay, I can. Can I change the alignment? I don't think I can. That doesn't matter too much though. Okay. I want to switch over to this other gray, but I don't know if it's the best time to do that yet. We'll do that right now. Oh god. 1, 2, 3. Alright. Fixed. We're good. So I have the default, where is the default template? This is the default template. Where am I using it? I think I'm just using it on like any page that doesn't explicitly have a thing set like this. Okay, yeah, this needs to, we need to update this. So the default template, it's gonna be a documentation page. Oh no, it's not actually. Hmm, interesting. Because all doc pages will have a doc layout, I think. So default should just not really be anything. I can just leave default as it is for now. Like this, and then mark.layout, this is the one that we wanted. So that kind of already looks like this, to be honest. I do have this, let me check that I can get that working properly. So we're gonna have eventually content in that box, side nav bg. So if I do array from length 10, map item div, hold on, if I do box, and I go key, EI, and then I say, hey, give me a width of 100% and a height of 24 pixels. Oh, and I need a background color, tomato. Okay, that's a lot of boxes. I think they were right next. Yeah, they were probably just... Ah, see, that goes all the way to the top. That is not what we want. So, that's 10 of them. I need to space them out. So, let me do display, flex. Flex direction columns. So they stack on top of each other. With a gap of. Ooh, I think 8, no, 3, 4, I think 4 is 1 RAM, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, okay, so 9 and 10 must be above, so I need to actually push this down, I need to apply the same margin, or, oh yeah, wait, I should just do that on this whole thing then, in that case. Here we go. That's applying to this and this now. It's just on this whole container. So that's 10. Oops, I'm covering the chat. What I need to do now is set this to scroll. So what I'm gonna do probably is make this a minimum height. And I also need to make the height of this whole container this minus the nav height. We go. So now they can scroll independently. I'll probably want to put some padding inside here because otherwise the links are going to be squashed up all against the side. Move this up here. I don't remember which value corresponds. I think it's 1. No, that's gonna be. Maybe it's. I think it's 4. I'll double check. Oh yeah, 4 is 1 rep. Okay. So the other complications, well, slight complication will be the menu because I'll need to generate that from the pages that we have. That's okay. Figure that out at some point. I'm gonna try not have a too late stream today, just because I don't want to. I'm feeling pretty tired today. If you couldn't tell by me yawning, so I won't be on too long. But I do want to get some stuff done. Okay, so I already have this kind of page set up already, like this container. We have that here. It's working well, so I think this is actually kind of done, maybe, in terms of page layout, at least. What I will need to do is, oh, you know what, let me change tomato to gray, 500. What I do need to do is fix my headers, because when I installed Shark Crew UI, it reset the headers. So For instance, if I go back to this and I have heading one, heading two, heading three, four, they will all look the same. Even though they are technically H1, H2, H3. So that is okay. We actually just need to fix this. So because we have a custom node for the headings over here, I think this is where we will want to do that. So Markdoc came with this heading component to generate these H1s. I'm pretty sure it would do this even without that, but whatever. Maybe I can rework this, I'm not sure. But I do need to give it, I do need to replace it with typography, so that's the only thing. Let me do a test. I don't return this. What if I return type heading? Because that's the shock UI thingy. Maybe I can't actually even call it heading. Oh, you know what? I can do this. Import heading as C heading? Oh, shuck. We're a heading. I'll just call it that. Totes, what's up? Hello. How are you doing today? How goes the gardening? Okay, let's do that. And I think I can do as. H level. Oh, it's not gonna like that, is it? It wants me to do like H1. But you have to just trust me. Trust me. Not assignable to type of view. Can I convince you otherwise? What would the HTML, what like the H1 attribute be called? I'm doing alright, gardening is also good, nice! I think after lunch I'm gonna go check and see if the spray I used last night got rid. The aphids. Ooh. Well, I hope it did. Either that or they had a hasty feast last night. Hopefully it's the former. I heard that they banned, over here at least, they banned the pesticide for snails. So there's, I don't think there's any like snail, what do you call that, like pellets anymore? Like it's been completely banned. I'm not sure what people are using now. I think you kind of just have to get rid of them by hand, which seems a bit tedious. Either that or home remedies. HTML heading attribute TypeScript. ID heading element HTML heading. What do you call that? It's like a Oh, hold on. I mean, I don't really want to do that. My Bandeer repellent I have left over because it's not in stores anymore. Yeah, that's probably what happened. They did the same thing with the snail stuff over here, because it's like, they just got rid of the existing stock that they had, so it's no longer stores, and you're supposed to use it up technically from your stores, or dispose of it. It's apparently quite toxic to fish, it's just pepper spray you put on leaves, you know. I mean, I don't know, like, I guess... The concern is probably when it rains, it washes off, and then eventually it gets to the sea or something like that. I feel like that's probably where that came from. At least for my vague, what do you call that? Like, elementary school geography. The water cycle, something like that. I don't know how to get these. Bruh. As any signable to type view. With as type of HTML heading element. Document type node, element node. It's like a kind of node, isn't it? It's like, I don't know. It's a node. I feel like. I'm using up the last of my bug spray that I saw in the stores carrying insecticidal soap, so I'll use that from now on. Nice. Insecticidal, that's a funny word. Insecticidal. See. Node name? No. It's weird because it's just like it's the name of the actual. There's a translate? I had no idea. Parent node? No, it's not that. What is it? TypeScript HTML. What is type of H1, H2, H3? Not really giving me the information that I want. It's like a tag. I guess it's like a tag. Tag name. That's annoying. You know what I should do? What if I do this? Key of... Oh, sorry. Type. Heading. Type. H1. H2. H3. And I just do this. Okay. It's satisfied now, at least. And then I can add class names to this. Oh, it's not gonna let me do that. Do this. Okay. I think that is it. Give it an ID. I also need to give it a size. Oh, this is actually going to be annoying. How do I do this? Joseph Dota, what is up? Hello, how are you doing today? How's your weekend going? I'm just gonna experiment with this and see what happens. Six. Will be small. Heading props. So what I can do is I can be like, hey, this is a record of heading type against heading props size. Yes. So I can make this extra small. Make this extra. Oh, I don't want it done large. This is kind of just a guess. I don't know. This is gonna necessarily map to the sizes that I'm thinking of. But it is worth a shot. Maybe I make this. I feel like this is gonna be the wrong scale. Let's see how this goes. Pretty good. What about me? I'm doing good, thank you. Thanks for asking. Yeah. Had a bit of a busy day, but probably getting back to things. Advanced level. Equals as heading. Oop. Heading. Oh, tag, call it tag. And then I'll just put tag here as tag. And then I'll put tag here. Ta-da! Where is our headings? Bruh, they just disappeared. Well, this is great. They were right here. Oh, here they are. Oh. No. Content should be there. Oh, because we don't have any children. We didn't actually give it any children. Put the children here. There we go. Hey, we have our headings. Nice. I'm actually going to get rid of this because we can do it this way now. So that means we've just basically mapped the chakra size of the heading to the type of tag, so H1, H2, H3. And that means that I can do this, and then we can get all different types of sizes now. Heading 5. Heading 6. Hey, nice. Mr. TSD, hello. How are you doing? Good to see you. Are you doing everything with coding? Am I doing everything with coding? How do you mean? Like, on the stream? Or what? I feel like my mic's, like, really high. If I'm too loud, let me know. I can turn it down. I don't want to be too loud. I'm good working on a League of Legends API wrapper for my app. It's iffy. Oh, that sounds pretty cool. I don't play much League, but what kind of stuff does it do? Does it like give you your rank and... Is it ELO? Is that the right term? I don't know. I don't play enough League to know. Everything you do, I see you do with coding. Yes. So I do a lot of coding. I did play games. I do kind of still play games from time to time. It kind of just depends on the game. But yeah, I do a lot of just random stuff, to be honest. Coding-wise, I kind of just work on stream projects. Like, this is for my website thing here for streamers to use for their Twitch chat for like different bots like Stream Elements and Nightbot and stuff. So I'm kind of just working on that and experimenting with new stuff as well. Let me see. Yeah. Well, I'm pretty pleased we got the heading working. Can I do this now? Is that going to be right up against the content? It is. Okay, that's a big no-no. We don't want that. So we need to actually put a class here. We're going to be like... I think I need to give it a heading class, actually. No, I'm going to just say... margin bottom 4. That's gonna give it. It's not gonna give it. Weird. They have some weird API stuff. Their client actually exposes an API based Swagger instance when you start it up, but you need to hack some stuff around it. Oh, interesting. I've been meaning to try and dig into the API for Apex Legends because I think that would be really cool, but I don't have enough knowledge of how to look at that yet. It would be nice if they could just release a public thing, because I feel like you could build a lot of really cool stuff around that. Did you make your panels with coding too? The panels in my Twitch bio I did in Illustrator. That would be pretty insane to do with code. I'm not much of a graphic designer, but I'm pretty happy with how those turned out. I just wanted something sort of, I don't know, stylish. It's kind of basic looking, but I like them. Firuzi, fake fire, how's it going? Thank you for the honk. So thirsty today, I don't know why. I have margin bottom on this class, but it's not working. That's kind of upsetting. Oh. Because I don't need that. Bruh. You just do this. And I can do this. I don't know why I was thinking I needed to do the other thing. There we go. Now we have a little padding under here, so when we do headers, they're not going to just be all stuck next to each other. There we go. So I can be like, hello. Welcome to the website. Enjoy your stay. That's pretty big. I can do this, make it smaller. Now that's working. Nice. So we fixed the header, that's good. Like you need to get pub ID, instance ID, in which port changes PCP. Yeah, those are the worst because like then it's limited to the instance that you have. And whereas it'd just be nicer if they just release a proper API. I can imagine them, like, I can understand them not wanting to because I don't know, maybe they're imagining abuse or whatever. So, what am I working on today? Basically, that is a good question. I am working on redoing or upgrading my old documentation site. So this is from 2019. The Fire API. So you can use this with different bots. And you can basically like make, use it to do pastebin stuff on pastebin. I don't remember. I think I might have added commands like this for Kaz's stream. At one point, I feel like I did. And yeah, can do some pretty cool stuff with it. But this site is old, and I kind of want to redo it. This is the only thing I'm not 100% sure about is this last updated thing, because this is technically, I think this is metadata from Git, like when it's been committed. I don't know if it's possible to get that. Like, how to see the git commit date. JavaScript. Get lost commit date. I don't think I can do this. Get lost commit date Next.js. I wanted to use the API. Maybe this is not possible. I mean, that's okay. I year. Cool, cool. I think I want to change, style this. This LI thing is kind of, yikes. What if I do margin right, margin left, okay, so that brings it inside at least. And then I do padding one rem. I think that might work, or maybe I do 0.5. No, I like one actually. Move that over to our globals. UL. Bro, what? In line. Something is wrong. Why is this taking precedence? Where is this in line? Coming straight from here, I think. No, it's not. What? I don't want to slap down an exclamation important, but I might have to. Don't want to, but it looks like this may be forcing my hands. I don't know where this is coming from. I think this is just on the UL when it's generated, but there's no like style thing, so this is coming from somewhere else. Inline style sheet. Or we could make a list component, but that sounds a bit extreme. So maybe we won't do that. I don't know if I even have. Do I have those? I don't think I do. Oh, you know what headings do you have? This little anchor thing for getting the fragment of the page. Might need to put that in. We have these little callouts. We technically we have a callout, but I'm going to maybe edit this those styles. Okay, yeah, I don't think we really even have any what do you call that? Bullet point lists. Oh, we do actually. Damn. But maybe I could change that style, but it would be nice to have them regardless. Huh. makes things complicated. Let me think. All right. Let me just check what happens if I put in the important. It'll fix it, won't it? Yeah, maybe we just do that because I don't think there's any other way to get around that. If it causes problems later down the line, we'll take them out. Right. How does that work? But the other thing doesn't. Oh, because Chakra reset it, I forgot. I wonder if, what if I put that in here? Give me a second. I put it in this. Whoa, there. Oh. Hold on. This is supposed to be like this. Okay, we'll do that. That overrides the chakra styling properly. We should probably actually put table stuff in here. Oh yeah, I should do that. And we can do a dark mode. Oh no, can we? I'll just leave it for now. All right, let's see. I want to do this. Here we go. Get rid of this. So we have our delicious looking stuff. You know what, the table, I'm just gonna leave that for now. Let's try and put in a, what do you call it? Thing. So we have getting started, that is the main first page. Support. That's its own page. That's under introduction. So would introduction be older? No. That doesn't really make sense. I guess it depends how I want to do these pages, because I could do pastebin as one, like this is technically one file, like it's the entire file, and each of these are segments, fragments even. Oh, yeah, I should do that for the heading. Or I can make these separate pages, but then you would need to switch pages. Which isn't bad, because you can see it on the side. I wonder if that's easier. It might be easier. Well, not easier, but more effective. Then again, having it on one page is like less navigation time. I don't know. I don't know what the usual thing you'd do. Okay, I think what I'll do is I'll just work on the heading bit for now, and that might bring me up to the end of the hour. It might be when I end, but we'll see. Alright, so technically all headings have this little thing on the side, so that's probably what we want to add. This is our heading component, and what we want to be able to say is... Oh, this is going to be tricky actually, because the headings aren't going to know what, like, where they are. Or will they? I don't know. Let me see. Where are these console logs happening, and can I get rid of them? Yes, get rid of those. Ugh, it's so good. I'm really glad that I got that working. Okay, so on heading, we have the heading. And then I need to put on the side, actually, let me do this. Console log. Window location. Let me just do that. Ah, so it does know it where it is. No, it doesn't because of that. So I need to do this on a use effect, I think. Because once, when it's mounted, it'll be able to know. So then, what if I do this? Box. Div. Box. Okay, and then what I do is I put a link here. link icon. Icon or type. I don't know how this works. Shocker UI, Shocker UI icons. Oh, I have to install it? Don't tell me I have to install it. Link icon. Oh, I just import it. I don't know how many icons I'm going to be using, but I guess I'll do it. Can I just do this? Link icon. No, we can't resolve it. I need to rebuild Docker. Hold on. Docker compose down. Wait, let me check if it's already down. Oh, I can do build and put it back up. So I'm getting this link icon so I can copy it on the side, and then I can press it on the side and now copy the URL to that URL in fragment. Real Zillion, what is up? Whoa, how is your Saturday going? Hope it's going well. Just waiting for this image to build. Not much, woke up late. Hey, that's what the weekend is for. Get that sleep in. It's good for you. I would have slept in today as well, but unfortunately I had chores to do. So, to take care of those things. And that's probably why I'm yawning on the stream today. I don't want to go too late. Oh, 5 p.m. late. Well, I mean, hey, don't know what time you went to bed, but I don't know. I mean, I've had my fair share of, I mean, back in school, my sleep was pretty messed up. Thankfully, it's been okay since I left, but yeah, I can sympathize. It's a tough cycle to break out of, though, if you don't reset it. Soon. I've sort of just accepted that I won't have good sleep. Yeah, I think I was like that at one point. I just, no matter what I do, just not gonna be perfect. Like, my body's was kind of just accepted 4 to 5 hours of sleep a night, and you know what, it's probably not healthy, but it's okay, I can deal with it right now. All right, this should be back up. What, didn't I just install this? Yes. I don't. Oh no. Let's just. Right. Wait, what's going on? Take the win if I get into bed by midnight. Yup. So what am I doing today? Good question. I am working on rebuilding my old documentation site. So this was done in VuePress, and basically I am redoing this in Next.js and Markdoc, which is a Markdown-based authoring system by Stripe. So on this one I used VuePress, which is kind of similar. You use Markdown to like write all this stuff. But I wanted to do something new because I haven't updated the site since 2019, so I'm making it a better because there's a lot of stuff that I didn't do well with this site. A lot of the styling being inline for one, which you can't really tell here, but when I switch to dark mode, you can see that all the styling is just. It's kind of all there, so we're taking a better approach to that. Doesn't Rust's website use Markdoc to generate their documentation? I'm not sure. Markdoc came out like last month, so if the documentation for Rust was done recently, then possibly, but I imagine that's doubtful. You might be thinking of something else. I think there's a few things called Markdoc out there already. It doesn't generate documentation per se, it's more of just like a way to write documentation, if that makes sense. So you can write everything in Markdown, like this, where is it? I don't think this is gonna work because of this icon. Damn, icon's not working. So this page, for example, is this file here, index.md. So earlier, just now actually, got this heading node working, so I'm using Chakra heading, because technically when you install Chakra UI, which is a component library, it resets all the styles, so all my headers just got yeeted back into the Stone Age. Everything looked the same. So now I've replaced all the headers with the actual Chakra headers, and then the different sizes as well. So I'm actually going to call this sizes. Let's do that. What I am doing immediately right now, though, is getting the little functionality for this anchor working. So here you could click the icon. And then it would give you that. I think what I'm gonna do is when you click it, it also sees it. Yeah, that'd be good. I think most documentation sites do that now. It's a little anchor as well, which I thought was really cute. Actually, no, I think I might have set that myself. It was probably a link icon before, but then I set it to be an anchor in the settings. I might make that a bit more thematic. Maybe I can make it a piece of fire is too. Oh no, I could make it a fire, like a fire emoji or something. Speaking of not updated for a while, I have to convert my WordPress kit to another one soon. Oh no. Why? WordPress is pretty popular. It's a reason why it's like 70% of the web or something like that. Plugin I use to power my comic has been wasted. Oh, I see. Damn. So is there like a security vulnerability, or is it just like not working? Because WordPress has been updated. That sucks. Asahi, what's up? Docker should use the anchor. Actually, that's a good thing, because that's like ships, right? Ships and whales. Oh, they have a boring old link. Look at that. Oh, yikes. And the actual... That's funny. The actual... Because the top of the page is technically behind this header, it goes, like, right up there, so you technically can't see it when you click it. I've run into that issue before on other things, and you kind of have to account for that, the heading size. Thankfully, on ViewPress, it already takes care of that, which is quite nice. I'll have to take that into consideration. Did I get this icon thing working? I don't know. Goost! Hello, how are you doing? How is your weekend going? Still light mode, yes. No. There is no light mode happening. It's all good. I was just checking something. There's no such thing as light mode. I think it's more security related because it works fine, at least from what I need from it. I feel like WordPress has security vulnerabilities like at least every couple months. It makes sense. It's like 70% of the web, so people are always going to try and break into it or whatever.
Yeah.
How am I holding up? Oh, you know what? I'm okay. I have to keep an eye on the lighting because otherwise I'm gonna turn the wrong color. Eventually. I'm probably gonna end stream before that though, because I'm pretty tired today. I need to not go so late. I'm well. Spent the morning getting my car service, getting ready to join Thrax Curse stream later. Oh, yes. Ooh. It's not Left 4 Dead today, is it? Because you finished. Congrats, by the way. It's a big achievement. Thank you for the moo. Plugin doesn't really do much other than act as an organizer, so I'm sure there's much. Gotcha. Hey, maybe you can make your own WordPress. It's funny because I actually have that documented right up here. Oh wait, what? They got rid of it? Bruh. I literally have that bookmark for that purpose and they got rid of it. It sucks. Yeah, I was working on a WordPress plugin. I kind of stopped because I got busy with other stuff, but it was actually a lot of fun. There's a lot more React under WordPress than you would assume, which is pretty cool, because you basically have access to the entire editor. It's basically like making custom widgets in Stream Elements. You make a custom block. trying to think of a strategy to speed up my scraper. Oh, what are you scraping? You don't mind me asking. Monster Prom Punishment Roulette. Oh, that's right. I do not know what that game is, but it sounds interesting. I didn't sign up for it. I was told I was going to do it, and then I didn't have a choice. Well, you are part of this squad, so, you know, you have kind of have an obligation there. That's just how the cookie crumbles, as Jim Carrey would say. I'm gonna try this again and it's gonna complain and I have no idea why. You know what? I have an idea. Watch this. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do system or docker system prune to delete the image. And then I'm going to do docker compose build no cache. And we're just gonna see if that works. And now I have to wait another minute. Great. Movies. Oh, that's right. It's for your, you're working on, am I thinking of the right person? You're working on a movie, pub. Yes. Yeah, I remember now. Nice. How long does it normally take to run? Like a full pass. That's the thing I usually find annoying about having to, when you're working on stuff like coding and having to wait for things. I think a lot of DevOps especially is waiting because you have to like wait for things to propagate. It would drive me up the wall. I had to just constantly wait for stuff. Oh, 40 hours. Full pass of 300 movies. It's around 90 seconds. All one single process. Ooh. Sounds... Wait, so what do you mean by... Oh, I see. Right. No worries, this I get your food. 300 movies in parallel seems pretty, reasonable. I don't know if I should ask how many movies are there in total. I'm assuming a lot. Alright, we have this done. Docker compose. Oh. See if this worked. We rebuilt it. From cat, with no cache. Hey, it worked! We have a little icon-y icon up there. Nice. Okay. I don't think there's a fire icon, is there? Why would there be? Like, well, let's be real. No, there isn't. I didn't think so. I can make one. I'm not gonna do that right now. I might. Maybe I'll do that in another stream. I just wanna see if I can get this working at least. So I have my link icon, I have this box. I technically need these to be on the same line, so I'm just gonna do display flex to make them on the same row. Line item center. Oh, I need to put the margin bottom on the actual thing, not on the heading itself. Here we go. On the icon, I can be like padding right one rem. Oh, I didn't want that. Margin right. Then I can make that half rem. And then I can do margin left minus 2. Minus 4, because it's two of them. Wait. Oh. Wait, what? Oh, because it's one rem indented, so I need to do actually 2 plus 6, so I need to make this minus 6. That's still pretty, I feel like that, actually no, that's a decent amount away. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm not too much of a too knowledgeable on scraping, so I'll defer to other resources, unfortunately. But sounds like an interesting task. Size. How do I make this smaller? Where is the icon? Oh, it's just width. Okay. Can I say 4? Height 4? Box size prop is to change the actual... Oh! Quite big. Bruh, okay, never mind. What if I do 2-2? Am I doing this wrong? There's no good example in the actual... Width 2. Size 2. Oh, maybe I just make this 1. There we go. 2. So, oh, this is an actual pixel based size. Okay, so I can do 1 rem. I can do 0.75 rem. Okay, nice. In that case, I'm going to make this 1.5. No, no. Maybe I just leave out 1. That was the default, right? Yeah, okay. Well, I'll just leave it at 1 for now. What I'm gonna do is now try and make that... okay. Can I set the opacity of this to be 0.3? How did it handle it here? Oh, so you don't see it until you hover over this. Okay. So, I shouldn't see this at all until I'm hovering over this. So what I'm gonna do is get a use state. Saved over 150 hours. What's the thing? Oh god. It's a lot of... It's a lot of movies. Oh, so this is this the total amount? And then you're doing 300 at a time? Damn. Well, am I correct in thinking that at least when you run it once, you don't have to really do it again? Because I'm imagining... The data is not really going to change, right? So you only need to run it again and to get new movies. Let's see, if I do use state advanced is hovering or hovering, I'm just going to do hovering, set hovering, use state false, then on. Gonna do pointer over because that will cover mouse as well. Pointer enter. Set hovering. True. And pointer. Leave. That's hovering false. And then this is only going to appear when you're hovering. And this itself is only going to be hovering the link. So this will be hovering anchor. Sets hovering anchor. Whoops. Didn't mean to click that. It's here. And then opacity. Depending on hovering anchor, going to be either 1 or 0.3. That's just a start value. Oh, I see. There's an amount of 700,000 movies. That's a lot of movies. Damn. I mean, I guess that makes sense. If that's like every movie ever. Ooh. Oh, I see. I need to take into account. You know what? Maybe we don't even bother with this then. I do need the margin bottom. I think what I'll do with the link is just make this hover. Absolutely. Right. Or left, I should say. -100 -24 low. I think I need to set the position of this to be relative. Hey, there we go. So now it's not going to affect. I don't need to bother about margins. Just set it to the other side. Is this a... Frank Sinatra. Am I thinking of the right song? It was Fly Me to the Moon. I thought I could vaguely make out the words of that. Just from the tune. That was weird. Future Funk sang Frank Sinatra is not something I thought I'd hear today. Okay, so when I'm hovering over this... Oh, wait. Oh, that doesn't take into account this because... Yeah, this is Fly Me to the Moon. That's so cool. I don't know why I find that really... funny. Um, How do I get to this icon? Oh, because it doesn't exist, right? Okay, don't leave. There we go. So now I can inspect this. Oh, okay, that's kind of annoying. I need to somehow... How is this doing it? Oh, that's the same thing. And it's an A. And it's just part of the heading. Actually, that does make sense. What if I make the width on this 100? Still doesn't count, okay. Let me put this here. And then put this here. Okay, that's, it looks like it actually works. I need to make this width like 8. Right, 8. Okay, I need to make this smaller. It's taking on the font. Oh, maybe it's taking, because it's taking on the font size, I can do font size. Let me see. No. Oh, it's just, all right, yeah. Maybe I make these 1.2. It looks like it works. Okay, and I think I just copied this over here. I don't actually need that. I might not actually even need this box. Oh no. Is it still outside the flow? Let me see. Where is this? Is that just... What if I just do this? I'm just trying to think on this. I have this hover. It's suddenly visible. Is this technically, this is not in the flow. This is off to the side. Float left, heading right, margin top. Oh. Who uses float nowadays, though? Let's be real. Interesting. Okay. I think what I can just do is when I set hovering anchor to true, I also set this to true. So maybe what I can do is then I'm doing both at the same time. Let me see. Const on hover anchor. On unhover anchor. And then I just do this. On unhover anchor. Oh, because we're doing both at the same time. Interesting. You know what? I think I have a better idea of how to approach this. I think I'll leave this here. And I'll leave this here. And I'll get rid of this. And what I do instead is instead of doing hovering like this, how did I have it before? A box. This was inside the box, and I had this up here. Oh, and then this was on the box. Oh no, sorry, this was on the box. Okay, and then I also had this. This was up here. But then instead of this, what I will do is I will put the margin right on this. But instead of conditionally rendering this here, what I'll just do is set visibility to hovering visible, otherwise hidden. So those will always exist now. Um, this one rem. And then what I can do is I can make the margin left on this be negative 1 rem, 2 rem. No. What is the space on this? Something's wrong. I think it might be because of the size. Yeah, so it was the 0.2. So if I made this 0.2, there we go. But now the hovering is true on this because of this margin. So I wonder if I make this padding instead. Wait. Whoa, why is that so small? Oh god. Oh, hold on. Why is this like that? Okay. Hey, there we go. Kind of. And I just need to set pointer true. Cursor pointer. I think I'm gonna try. I might be able to get the absolute method working, but all right, whatever. Now I just need to set this so that when you click it, and it will click. Console log window location href. Okay. And now with the ID. Hey. So I go to this URL. Does that go down to that? I can't really tell because it's really up here. What if I do this? Let me make it like this. Oh, it does, I think. I need to put a heading further down and see. Like, below this table, maybe? Wowee. If I do wowee, Oh, it's not going to go to that. What if I make this a link? Should I do that? I technically make this a link. Import link from next link. Oh, right. I guess I can't do that without sacrificing the box, so I need to wrap link in box. Gonna do this. A link down here. href. Oh, import link from next link. And then the href of this is gonna be do this. Gonna complain because window doesn't exist. Then we're just gonna do this window. Oh my gosh. Type of window does e not equal undefined. I don't know how I feel about that. I think that's happening because oh God, it keeps going. I do this without the fragment. Console log window location. Feel like that's a thing. Oh, wrong site. Okay, so that's the hash. We technically only want the origin and the path name. Oh, sorry. Yeah, the origin and the path name, and then the new fragment. So we don't want to just keep using href because otherwise we're going to keep tagging on the other hashes. So let's do where is this href? What I can actually do is do a use memo instead. So const url equals use memo, because that way we can have this come like from window. Actually, we don't even need window because it will just, when this mounts, it will change. So we need window location. Post name, path name, ID. Is it host or host name? Oh, no, it's neither, it's origin. And then it's path name. And then this URL should be this, like so. And I can make this just URL. to. Window is still undefined. But it should be when this mounts. Oh, that's annoying. Where is window being used? Window. Just up here, okay. Hmm. In that case, I'll do type of window is not equal undefined. Return nothing. It's kind of working. This is complaining about something. Oh, there's double slashes. Oh, there we go. Hey, it's working. It's going to that link. I think I can then go back because it's still in the link. Nice. Can I enable smooth scrolling on the body, I wonder? Let me see if I go to theme config, styles, global, HTML. What is the thing? It's like smooth or scroll behavior, I think. Smooth. What is the thing? What is scroll behavior? Does it go, where does it go on the body? I think it goes on the body actually. Oh, it doesn't. Maybe it goes on Oh, you know what? It doesn't go on the body because I've already disabled I've already disabled overflow, like, to support this like, you can see that the scrolling is happening in this container, so I actually need to apply a smooth. Oh, okay, let me try doing that on this. Where am I even working? Which, this is feature, so this will just be... Oh, this is a dock. So this is this layout. So see here where I have overflow Y auto. That's because the scrolling is happening here. So... I actually need that to be on this side. Scroll behavior smooth. Ah, oh, there we go. That's pretty cool. I can press back and it will like go to that different part. Nice. Now all I need to do is have it copy the URL to the keyboard, I think, to the thing. So that should be easy enough. Heading, what I want to do is handle click. Instead of logging at the URL, I will just get it to, I don't know if I need use memo for this actually. I'm just gonna do this. Get rid of use memo. What I'm gonna do is do if navigate clipboards. Turn. Otherwise, navigator, clipboard, write text, URL, or URL link. Never. See if this works. I'm just going to copy this. Hey, it worked. Nice. So that is actually copying the link to the clipboard now, every time we click the the anchor. That's pretty cool. The only thing I'm slightly concerned about is the animation of the header. It looks like it's broke. I wonder if that's to do with this heading. Or if it's to do with this. I don't, can't tell. I'm gonna get rid, so where is it? Index. I'm gonna get rid of these titles. Oh, it's not to do with those. Something else. Is it to do with the layouts? Is it happening to the other layouts? No, it's not happening here. Something wrong. If it's, is it the table? Nope. Did I change something here, I wonder? I don't think so. Not to do with this. It's only happening here, so I wonder if it's to do with... What did I change? I don't think I changed anything. Maybe it's this? This was Oh, this was the children actually, so maybe it was this. Weird. I don't think it's that. I don't know. Something's wrong. I just realized I'm really dark. I don't think I'm going to be on much longer. It's already a bit past what I said I was going to go up to, but let me just turn this on for now. I want to at least figure out why this... I want to figure out why this animation seems to have broken now. See, what is causing that? It's not the favicons. Let me just restart Docker case. Let me just broke. Do this actually. Things up. What if it's not gonna be this, because this is related to the table. Not that. Wasn't the headers? Was it the style? This? Wasn't this? Oh, this seems fixed again. Weird. Oh, maybe it was the headings. Yeah, I think it was the headings. Because look, you can see that this is actually gone further up now. Because that's where it's supposed to be. I'd originally pushed this down, but it's causing that to break. I don't know if I fix for that. So on this, where is this? This dock. If I do this. Oh, not this. That does put that down there, but now that's like skipping up. So that's kind of annoying. I think, oh, maybe what I can do is... oh no, that's not even related to that. This is the height of this. It's the margin top, I think I moved. Yeah, here. So what I could try and do is put that on the... Instead of putting that on the page... Yeah, I put that on this. And on this. Let's move that down. But I still get that smooth transition there. Oh, I think I fixed it. Nice. And I have also this nice scroll. I do want to add it. I wonder if I can add a bit of padding to that. I think I can. Well, maybe I can actually. Because the headings. Where's the heading? If I do margin bottom, I can do margin top 2. Or even 4. Oh, that still brings it to there. That's not good. Can I do, is it padding maybe? No. I don't know if there's a way to do that. Seem to always just go there. To that fragment. Well, I guess that's good enough. Where did the wow go? Oh, yeah, because I deleted it. It's technically still centered. Alright, well... I did fix what I set out to fix, so maybe I should leave it there. I'm gonna probably going to be working on some other layout related stuff. Let's see. Is there anything else? I'm probably going to redo the routes off stream as well. So right now you can see they will just say feature 2, feature 3, but I only did that for a demo. I'm going to obviously rename those folders appropriately. And that will be reflected in the final routes. I just need to match them up to what the pages are right now, which is like pastebin and whatever other stuff I've worked on. I want to eventually like throw other things in there as well, so it's just not, it's not going to be documentation for API. It will be like maybe for widgets and things like that. So that's kind of why I've left it open ended. I'll probably have an API folder. It's not all going to be API documentation. Probably widget stuff and maybe other things that I've worked on. Yeah, I think that's going to be fun. But for now, let's see. I think I will pass you off to who's on. Ooh, Dev Wars is on. Are they playing? What's happening? Let me see. Oh, I think they're looking for players. I'm probably not going to play because I played the week before last, or like last game. So not for me, but yeah. All right. Take care. And I will see you guys around. I don't know if I'll stream tomorrow. Maybe I will. We'll see. See if I can think of stuff to work on, because I kind of have this layout. Maybe I'll do, I could do the table of contents on the side. That might be fun to do. I'm glad we got this in though. That's pretty cool. I might replace this icon. But yeah, we'll see. All right, everyone, have a good rest of your Saturday. And I will catch you the next time. Peace.